That was Go Shibata Judo Tournament here in Texas. Hi, everybody. I'm Johnny Rivera Marquez with Judo Live Television, broadcasting on YouTube channel. Now, this camera, believe it or not, it's not the camera that I use to shoot all these videos. This camera is about 80 years old. But a camera similar to this one really helped publicize judo. And not only the camera, but the man behind it.
You started off with the Bible of Judo. And I was in 1962, and they said, look, this is the book that you need to get. It was The Sport of Judo. Why did you get interested in filming judo in particular?
Well, I've been a photographer for years, since I was a teenager. They were selling used speed graphics for $25.
Wow.
I said, well, get one, and I repaired it. It had holes in the bellows. I got new bellows.
Yeah, yeah.
I used to repair speed graphics and Graflexes. And so I put that thing together, put shoe polish on all the leather. When I was 16, I worked as a camera repair in Philadelphia during World War II. In fact, one of my customers was Jim Seeley, the guy that shot the Hindenburg. When that blew up, my discharge papers of the Army, and it tells the jobs I did. And I had two jobs. One was battalion photographer, and the other was a photography instructor.
And I didn't get into judo until I returned to Japan in 1950. It was, I think, late 51 or early 52.
So when I got into judo, it was like fighting, in a way. And the people in Japan were terrific. They liked the idea of a foreigner, you know, like build a bridge of friendship.
Yeah. And I had done wrestling and boxing, so I was already a scrapper. And I was a street fighter when I was a kid in South Philly. So I was always exposed to some kind of fighting when I was. So I went down to the Kodokan, and I saw, it was late, and there was just this old teacher throwing this young student around. I said, oh, heck, I can do that. You know, I thought that. And so I signed up, and that's how I got started in judo.
I learned from some of the old guys, they're legendary. And it really got to me, and my own level of expertise grew.
And there were great teachers. I mean, it was awesome at the Kodokan. I could practice with all Japan champions, or these old teachers that were remarkable. It was Kobayashi who became we wrote the book Sport of Judo. Sport of Judo, I was only a Shodan, first degree black belt, when we wrote that. And so we did techniques of judo. And later, I've produced some film on him. I had photographed him, and some of that now is in some of my classic judo series.
He put up his old still camera, and now he's sporting a brand new digital one. And he hasn't lost his touch. And people around the world still love him for what he's done for judo.
In Japan, he's considered a VIP in judo. I mean, his book, The Sport of Judo, really introduced judo to the West. And, you know, that was right after World War II when they had banned the practice of martial arts. And Sharp was able to articulate it in a Western dialogue. And to this day, he's still on the Hal Sharp teacher site. This is a guy who's still innovating in his mid-90s. It's incredible.
And in 2016, he was inducted into the USA Judo's Hall of Fame, along with many other judo legends. I'm Johnny Rivera Marquez with Judo Life Television on YouTube.